I don't have to change my game because this is still the same game. Or I should. I do need to change my dashboard. You'll figure out why I'm doing that very shortly, because I'm about to do something kind of different than what I normally do. Yep, we're going Type F today. There is very little chance that I'm going to pull off a 1cc in this game. But this game, I'm actually having more trouble with this game than Gradius 3. And you just saw me do Gradius 3. So I mean, might be onto something here. So you might be wondering why I'm choosing to play with Type F, and it's because I decided that, like, my problem with the bubble stage is that, like, I don't have enough, like, of a direct attack, and plus Type F is really useful for, like, it just focused firepower, and so it's really useful in the bubble stage. The only downside is, though, that some enemies are gonna be a little bit harder for kill. Also, my button config that I use for Gradius 3 doesn't work for this game. Because there's a lot of instances where I'm going to want the flying torpedoes to go all the way out. Which is why I assigned rapid missile to R1, and then normal missile is just going to be a circle. So for this stage, I'm going to be holding triangle and circle because I'm going to want my flying torpedoes to go all the way out. So I can do stuff like this. Because a lot of those hatches are really annoying to take out unless you just have missiles that can go all the way out. And that's kind of why the flying torpedo is kind of useful. I just camp out over there. And also they're useful for taking out some of these plant enemies because, as you can see, they're one of those missiles where if they hit the ground, they'll just go into land simply. Thank you. I did that without getting hit. That's not normal. This next day sucks. I don't know why, but I'm really bad at this next stage. With this weapon set, though, it is a little bit easier. Because, again, you have more focused firepower, and so it's a lot easier to take out the bubbles. Whereas with the other set, you just have the flying torpedoes that just go. What is? I don't even remember what they're called at this point. Are these the flying torpedoes? Vertical mines. Yeah, the vertical mines. I'm sorry, I forgot my Gradius lore for a little bit. Yeah, the vertical mines just flying all over the place, and it's not really that easy to hit any of the bubbles. But with this type, you can just focus all of your firepower on one thing. And plus, if you have rapid fire for both, it makes the stage a nice breather. Although, it can still be a pain, because these bubbles flying everywhere are just so bad. Because, like, they're so erratic once they break apart. Even on normal difficulty. And when there's a lot of them on screen at once, it can get very hectic. And it's very easy to have a bubble just come out of nowhere and completely bone you. Also, the crystals, when they're moving at high speeds, are very hard to dodge. Especially in this section, you have like two of them to dodge at the same time. Alright, right now I should be in the clear. That time I meant to grab that just for safety reasons. Options are useful weapons, aren't they? Yeah, you can see that, using that weapon set made that stage so much easier than if I were playing with Type F or Type E. It's also a lot easier for Bubble 4. Again, because of the more concentrated firepower. I should not have done that. Okay. It's not over yet, but we made it past the part that normally screws me. Alright, here's another stage where I'm going to want to be holding the circle button. There's a lot of ground enemies in this stage that I need to take care of. This is a stage that I would admit is a lot easier with the vertical mines, because with the vertical mines you can just launch them all over the place all willy-nilly. You know, it's just good to go. And also, you can farm from these volcanoes without having to worry about getting hit, and with Type F, you can't really do that. So I opt to play it safe there. Okay, and here's the reason why I activated my fourth option at a specific time, because it appears here, and I purposely let it take one, otherwise it'll bother you during the next stage. And I don't exactly know which is better to do here, so I'm just gonna rapid fire it. I am probably going to die here. Get a force field, please. Thank you. Yeah, the rank of this game is just crazy. Alright, you know what? Yeah, I'm just gonna do this. It'll make it much easier to hit. this. Shouts to the last attempt I did of this game where I lost focus on this stage for literally a second and it killed me. And I wasn't able to recover. Alright, this is officially the farthest I have made it in a while without dying. You want to activate your fourth option once the screen starts vertically scrolling, because then the option hunter appears in a very decent spot for you to be able to dodge it. Alright, I am already terrified. Where the game really starts to kick you in the balls. Because this stage is tough. Especially if you're like me and you just don't have a plan for it. You just go into it and go all willy-nilly and expect it to work out every time. I am probably going to die. You should never be that close to the front of the screen. Yeah. The good news about this game is that every time you die, the rank goes down. Right. And I'm only 6,000 points ahead of... I'm 6,000 points away from extra life, so... chill out. Alright, that was a badass recovery. Auto scroll for the win. If I die here, I'm just bad. I Okay, time for the worst stage in the game. That's not an exaggeration, the stage actually does kind of suck. The fact that I'm going into it off of recovery is probably not a good thing. Okay, I'm gonna use this blue capture to my advantage. Maybe not in my best interest to have done that. Okay, that's bullcrap. I'm not planning on attempting this hunt again if this is the attempt at game overs. I'll just accept the fact that this game is impossible. They didn't just come out, like, once every four frames or something. This section would be, like, so much easier. How does Aquas make this game look so easy? Okay, yeah, I think it's over. Unless the rank is just, like, super low right now. In which case, I'll be safe. Alright, screw options. I'm going straight for a force field. Yeah, bad idea. Alright, this game sucks. But that's the farthest I've made it in a while. I'm not attempting that again. Nope. This begs the question, do I want to do boss rush mode? I'll do it once. What the hell? Let me just change my button thing there. Oh, I was holding the wrong button, I'm pretty sure. Alright, for some reason I thought he was dead. For some reason my information also has a update. I didn't know I had update information. remember having speed strats for this guy, but I don't remember them at all. Now it's time for the hardest boss. I killed him there. Oh, God fucking damn it. Once again, Rain goes down for death. As you can see, it's already... his firing rate is slightly less frequent. Damn! Alright, I need to do it on this attack. I hate that final attack. Because, like, seriously, it's impossible to dodge if he's too close to the front of the screen. I have no idea how you're supposed to dodge it. Alright, as last year, Gradius IV was a train wreck. So now, let's switch PS2 games.